Hello, my dear students. So this is the next part of the periodic trends, okay, where we were discussing about the periodic trends of the S block elements. So we have completed the three properties, okay, that is about the atomic radius and the ionization enthalpy and the hydration enthalpy, how it varies along like a down the group, and some information regarding the group 1 and group 2, why they are called alkali metals, why they are called alkaline earth metals. Those all properties we have discussed, okay. Similarly, let us move to the next trends, that is density, melting point and the boiling point, as well as the metallic properties. So this is purely, this video is about the S block elements, okay. Yes, so at the end of the video we're going to get the properties, the clear picture of how the density, melting point and the boiling point and the metallic property will vary. If you like the video, okay, then I hope it will be useful. Yes, so let us start with the first one here, that is the density. Okay, as I have told, okay, there is a slight change or some of the exceptional case in case of a density. Okay, so usually the trend that we will try to understand, okay, so when I say density, we know that the formula density is equal to mass by volume. Okay, to remember, so as the mass increases, density also increases. If the volume increases, density decreases. Okay, here what happens, as we go down the group, there is an increase in the density. Okay, so as we go down the group, there is an increase in the density, except one or two cases. Okay, why as we go down the group the density increases, dear students? It is because the number of electron increases, means the atomic number increases. As the atomic number increases, the number of electron increases. At the same time, the protons increases as well as the neutrons. So I could say the atomic mass increases. So as the atomic mass increases, since it is directly proportional, so what I could say, density increases. Okay, so both the cases same over here, even for the group 1, group 2. Okay, so as we go down the group, the density goes on increasing. But do concentrate here. According to the trend, what should be that? The sodium should be, what we can say, lighter than the potassium. Means sodium should be of less denser than the potassium. Similarly, according to the trends, magnesium should be less denser than the calcium. But here what happens, there is a slight change that between the sodium and the potassium, sodium is heavy denser or have a high density than potassium. Similarly, between the magnesium and the calcium, magnesium is high denser than the calcium. So here comes the question, why it's supposed to happen like this. So dear students, I want to explain this in detail. Okay, so here I could write the trend. So as I could say, as we go down the group, first I'll just going to write the trend over here, then I'll going to explain why there is an exceptional cases. Fine. Yes, so lithium is less denser, okay, than potassium it should be, but here I'll just explain it. Sodium is more denser than the potassium. Okay, next, potassium is less denser than rubidium, followed by cesium, followed by francium. Okay, so this is an exceptional case. Similarly, beryllium, followed by magnesium, is more denser than the calcium, okay, and followed by here. Okay, this is what the trend we're going to see. Now let us discuss why. Let us discuss about the sodium and the potassium. Okay, so here, what is the atomic number of sodium, dear students? 11. So if I write 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1, this is what, sorry, you, yeah. So this is what the configuration. So here what is happening, you could see 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Okay, means the size of a sodium is less. Agree? Okay, so if the size is less, this outermost electron that is present in the s orbital finds more inward pull. What do you mean by inward pull? That since the size is very small, this outermost electron will get more attraction towards the nucleus. Okay, the protons that are present in the nucleus will try to attract these electrons more, so it will going to find the more inward pull. Yes, so here you could see this is a configuration of a sodium, dear students. Okay, so you could see here there is a last electron present in the s orbital. Okay, so let us write even for the potassium, then you could understand. Potassium atomic number is 19. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. Okay, 3p6, 4s1. Okay, so when you compare between the sodium and the potassium, the extra shell is added to the potassium. Agree? So it is the fourth shell is entering. Here we have a third shell. So the size of the sodium is very less, dear students, compared to the potassium. So what happens if the size is less? This outermost electron that are present in the sodium will find more inward pull. What do you mean by that? It is the outermost electron will get more attraction towards the nucleus. So what happens? The size decreases. Okay, size decreases means even the volume, what happens, goes on a decreasing. Atomic volume decreases. If the atomic volume decreases, what happens to the density, dear students? Density goes on increasing. Okay, but here what is happening, here what is happening, when it comes to potassium, the fourth shell is entering. So the size, what happens, increases as compared to the sodium. If the size increases, so that the outermost electron will not find that much of attraction towards the nucleus. So what happens? And there is an immediate presence of a 3D orbital over here. Okay, so what happens? The atomic volume goes on increasing. The atomic volume increases because of the less force of attraction. So as the atomic volume increases, what happens to the density? It decreases. Okay, so that's why what happens? Sodium is heavy denser than that of a potassium, but expected should be what? The reality, like, expected should be what? Potassium should be more denser than the sodium. It is because as we go down the group, the density goes on increasing. Okay, so this is what the trend, and this is what the explanation. The same thing you could explain between the magnesium and the calcium, the same explanation we could see over here. So the trend is like this. Okay, repeating. Okay, so that as we go down the group, there is an increase in the density, except some of the case between the sodium and the potassium and the magnesium and the calcium. Okay, yes. So next, let us move to the melting point and the boiling point. Okay, yes, dear students, when it comes to melting point and the boiling point, okay, there is what we could say, there is a gradual decrease in the melting and the boiling point. The melting and the boiling point goes on decreasing as we go down the group. Repeating, the melting and the boiling point goes on decreasing as we go down the group. Why? It's because, listen, very important. So group 1 and 2 are metallic in nature. Okay, group 1 and 2 are, that is, S block elements are highly metallic in nature. Okay, means what? There is an availability of what? The free electrons. Okay, so as we go down the group, what happens? The size goes on increasing, means the distance between the nucleus and the outermost electron increases. As the distance increases, obviously the outermost electrons are left free. If the outermost electron are left free, then what happens? It exhibit the metallic nature or the as the outermost electron left free, so very less temperature is required to melt and then to like a boiling point. Okay, so that's why what happens as we go down the group, the melting point and the boiling point goes on decreasing. That is a one property. So it can be explained in another way. Here we could see, but as compared to the group 2 and the group 1 elements, the group 1 elements have a less melting and the boiling point compared to the group 2. It's because, see, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and the francium all have a plus 1 charge. Means, okay, so there is a weak metallic bond is present. Okay, weak metallic bond is present between the nucleus and the outermost electron, since only one valency electrons over there. Okay, so weak metallic bond means I can break the bond very easily by giving a less temperature. But when it comes to the group 2 element, the charge is plus 2, means there is a what we could say, there is a presence of two electrons in the valency shell. So what happens, a strong metallic bond is present between the nucleus and the outermost these electrons. So it needs a more temperature to break that one. But the trend when it comes to an individual group, as we go down the group, the melting point and the boiling point goes on what? It decreases. Okay, similarly even for the group 2 elements, as we go down the group, the melting point and the boiling point goes on decreasing. Okay, so the trend we could find what? Lithium needs more what we can say, as we go down, decreases means lithium more, followed by sodium, followed by potassium, followed by rubidium, followed by francium. Similarly, beryllium needs more melting and the boiling point, followed by magnesium, followed by calcium, strontium and the beryllium. But there is an exceptional case over here for the magnesium. Okay, there is an exceptional case for the magnesium, where when it comes to these all elements, magnesium has got the lowest melting point and the boiling point. It's because of its crystal structure. Okay, this might be an important point over here. Magnesium has a very low melting point and the boiling point compared to all other elements. It is because of its crystal structure, and there is an HCP crystal structure exhibited by the magnesium, which is responsible for its low melting point and the boiling point. Okay, yes, so this is about the this property. And next comes the metallic property. As I told, and that is related here, metallic property means as we go down the group, the metallic property goes on increasing. It's because, as I told, the what we can say, the size goes on increasing. As we go down the group, the size goes on increasing, and there is a presence of a free electrons which makes the element to behave as a more metallic in nature. Okay, so as we go down the group, the metallic property goes on increasing. Okay, so I could write a lithium followed by sodium, followed by potassium, followed by rubidium, cesium and the francium. Similarly, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium and the barium, radium. Okay, so these are the three properties that we need to discuss. I hope you find it very useful. Some of the exceptional case also have discussed. Okay, similarly in the next video, let us discuss about its acidic property and reducing nature, electronegativity and the thermal stability. Okay, thank you.